project we'll be wrapping is a vase. This vase is cylindrical shaped, and so you can apply this wrapping style to any object that is also similarly shaped, with cylinder shaped. So the first thing that you need to do is to lay out the wrapping paper on a table, and the idea is that you need to figure out the length of paper that you need to cover the top of the vase and then secure it with the raffia at the top. So if you lay out the vase or the object in the center of your paper and lift up the sides of the paper toward the top. And you need to have enough paper at the top of the object, as I said, to be able to tie it together. Once you have figured out the length of paper that you need, you can cut your paper. Now that you have your piece of paper cut to the length that you need for your object, you need to pre-cut. It's a good idea to pre-cut some paper raffia to be able to tie the top, just to have it aside when you're ready to tie. So I'm just gonna cut a bit and put on the side so that I have it ready to go when I need it. So the first thing, wrapping a cylindrical object, is the contours are usually difficult, but it's best to start working with the edges, with the short length of the paper. So bring up the short length of the paper on one side, and then bring up the longer edge and create a fold, like that. Then take the other side and make another fold to cover up the top. And then just tighten the folds together like this. Do the same for the other side, and then bring up the tops together and tie them with your raffia. So now that you have all the edges tied together and no part of the vase showing, try to tuck the edges in a bit tighter and fold the edges and make them crisp so that they fold together nicely and bundle at the top without ripping the paper. It also helps just to make a little indentation at the bottom so that it creates more dimension and it looks more elegant. Being very careful not to rip the paper, try to bring together the top and then take your pre-cut piece of raffia and using one hand, loop the raffia twice around the top and then make a really tight knot. If you need to, you can just reposition the paper and tighten it even further so that there are no gaps. The final step is just to make it a bit more decorative. So you can take another color of raffia, make another bow, tie it, and then make the bow a bit puffier, as we showed you with the box. Open up the raffia on the loops of the bow, and then curl the edges of the raffia ends. So all you have to do is just make the ends nice and crisp, make sure all the edges are tucked in, and this is how to wrap a vase or any cylindrical object.